Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okay, we meet again in unit 4 now for 6th grade. Okay, we come in the first meeting, so we will discuss about vocabulary. Before we begin everything, let's pray together. Raise your hand, everyone. Okay, let's follow me. Okay, follow me. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Okay. Let's begin the lesson. Unit 4 for 6th grade English learning online with me, Mr. Agung. Okay, before we begin everything, prepare your book first. National Geographic Our World, student book 6. Okay. Open unit 4 with title Water. Water everywhere. Okay. If we take a look at the title, okay, and also the picture on page 56, okay, water, okay, we will discuss perhaps about water. As you know, our planet is consists a lot of water. Most of our planet covered with water, okay, in the sea, the lake, the river, and many more, okay, but for precisely in this unit we will discuss about, okay, identify types of water and their characteristic. Okay, describe recent activities, talk about saving and wasting water, and last, understand and explain statistics. Okay, jadi di unit 4 ini kita akan berbicara tentang water, air, di mana kita akan mengidentifikasi, ya, mengenali jenis-jenis air dan karakteristiknya. Ya, yang kedua, menjelaskan aktivitas yang baru terjadi. Tiga, berbicara tentang menyimpan air dan membuang air, membuang-buang air, wasting water. And the last one, understanding and explain statistic. Berusaha mengerti, ya, memahami dan menjelaskan tentang statistik. Okay, let's begin. Before we begin, there is two question. Okay, on the page 56, number one, this is a waterfall or b a wave. Number two, write your caption for the photo. Okay. Caption, ya, kutipan. Kira-kira jika kalian melihat ini, gambar halaman ini, halaman 56 ini, kira-kira kutipan apa yang cocok untuk gambar ini? Oke, okay. Ini juga ada video kecil. This also a video about unit 4. Oke, okay. Preface, unit 4. Let's see together.
Hi, Patty.
Hi, Rick.
That glass of water looks cool and delicious.
It is delicious. Rick, do you know where this water came from?
Of course I do. The water you're drinking came from that pitcher.
Well, yes, this water did come from the pitcher, but the pitcher isn't its origin. This water came from a lake that's far from the city. It took a long journey to get here.
Wow, that's cool. Today, we're going to learn all about water. Do you know where your water comes from?
We'll learn about where different forms of water come from, why it's important to protect water, and how we can conserve it. I'll sing a song about water.
We'll meet a National Geographic fellow, and I'll tell a story called The River Dragons.
That sounds great. Let's begin.
Okay, let's begin. Open your book on page 58. On page 58, there is 1, 2, 3. There is 3 texts explaining about water. Okay, I want you to listen carefully, dengarkan baik-baik, and also read the text like always.
Unit 4, Activity 1, Listen and Read.
Some of the most beautiful places on Earth are made up of water, oceans, rivers, waterfalls, and ice. Read about 3 famous wet places.
Okay. Some of the most beautiful places on Earth are made up of water. Okay, not big enough. Okay, oceans, rivers, waterfalls, and ice. Read about three famous wet places. Jadi beberapa tempat yang cantik di bumi ini ya terdiri dari air. Contohnya ada ocean, yaitu lautan, rivers, sungai, waterfalls, air terjun, dan ice. Oke, bacalah tentang ketiga tempat yang menakjubkan ini. Oke.
Do you like to soak your feet in the ocean? The salt water in the Dead Sea is good for your body. This sea is about 8 times saltier than an ocean. You can float on it. It is about 400 meters below sea level and is the world's deepest saltwater lake.
Okay. Do you like to soak your foot in the ocean? Apakah kamu suka merendam kakimu di lautan? Ya. The salt water in the Dead Sea is good for your body. Jadi air garam yang ada di laut mati, namanya laut mati, bagus untuk tubuhmu. This sea is about 8 times saltier than an ocean. Ya, di laut mati ini 8 kali lebih asin daripada laut yang lautan. You can float on it. Kamu bisa mengambang di lautan ini, di laut mati. Kira-kira laut mati ini berada di 400 meter di bawah permukaan laut. Jadi laut ini adalah laut yang terendah. Oke. Okay.
The beautiful Hubbard Glacier has been flowing slowly towards the ocean for centuries, carving rocks along the way. It is formed from drops of water that froze billions of years ago. Around 70% of fresh water on the planet's surface is frozen.
Okay, next is on the bottom, bawah. The beautiful Hubbard Glacier has been flowing slowly toward the ocean for centuries. Jadi, Glacier Hubbard yang cantik itu, ya, ini namanya ada Glacier Hubbard, ya. Sudah mengapung perlahan-lahan di lautan selama berabad-abad.
The Azmat Swamp is home to amazing animals.
Sorry. Carving rocks along the way. Ya. Memahat ketika glacier ini mengapung ini akan terjadi macam pahatan di sekitar glaciernya itu ya sepanjang perjalanan. Mengapungnya itu. It is formed from drop waters that froze billion of years ago. Jadi Hubbard Glacier ini terbuat ya, terbentuk oleh tetesan air yang membeku selama jutaan tahun yang lalu. Kemudian kira-kira 70% dari air segar ya, air yang bisa diminum, air minum di planet ini dalam fase membeku. Okay, next.
Animals like crocodiles, sea snakes, and Komodo dragons. These wetlands are important because they provide a home to many creatures and they control floods. Also, the plants filter dirty water and make it clean.
Okay, next is the Azmat Swamp. Ya, rawa Azmat. Azmat itu berarti ada di daerah Papua. Okay. The Azmat Swamp is the home to amazing animal like crocodiles, sea snakes, and Komodo dragons. Jadi rawa Azmat ini ya adalah rumah dari hewan-hewan yang menakjubkan seperti buaya, ular laut, dan juga komodo. These wetlands are important because they provide a home to many creatures. Jadi tanah yang basah ini, rawa-rawa ini sangat penting karena mereka menyediakan rumah bagi banyak makhluk. And they control flood, dan terlebih mereka mengendalikan banjir. Also the plants filter dirty water and make it clean. Juga tanaman yang ada di rawa-rawa ini akan menyaring air kotor dan membuatnya menjadi bersih. Oke, jadi di halaman ini, halaman 58 ini ada beberapa kosakata, ada vocabulary seperti waterfalls, wet, soak, salt water, sea, float, sea level, lake, glacier, carving, drops of water, froze, fresh water, swamp, filter. Ya, jadi ada tiga tempat, yaitu misalnya sea, dan glacier, and swamp. Waterfalls itu artinya air terjun. Oke, wet, basah. Soak itu merendam. Salt water artinya air asin, air garam. Sea, laut. Float itu mengambang. Sea level, permukaan laut, permukaan air laut. Lake, danau. Glacier itu es ya, dataran es, gumpalan es ya. Carving itu memahat. Drops of water itu tetesan air. Froze itu membeku. Fresh water itu air segar. Kemudian ada swamp itu rawa-rawa, dan filter itu menyaring. Jadi kata-kata berikut tadi yang Pak Kung sebutkan tadi yang bertuliskan tebal itu adalah kosakata atau vocabulary dari unit 4. Kalian pahami, bisa tulis di buku tulisnya. Karena siapa tahu Pak Kung keluarkan nanti. Oke. Kita lanjutkan lagi ke halaman selanjutnya, yaitu halaman 60. Oke, on page 60, ya, there is a song, ada lagu. Oke, a world of water, jadi dunia air. Oke, I'll try to play the video. Oke, because several time I only play the sound. I'd like to play the video this time. Ya, Pak Kung putarkan videonya karena beberapa kali dari unit 1 sampai dengan unit 3 kemarin Pak Kung hanya memutarkan rekamannya aja. Sekarang Pak Kung ingin coba putarkan videonya. Perhatikan videonya, kalian baca, kalian sama ikuti liriknya.
Hi everybody, are you ready for a song? This song is all about water.
A world of wonder, a world of water. I've been thinking about all the water in our world. A world of wonder, a world of water. I've been thinking about all the water in our world. There's water in lakes and water in the sea. There's even water in you and me. A puddle of water, a waterfall. A tall glass of water, I love it all.
Fresh water, salt water, water in the sink. I've been taking some time to think about how much water there is in the world. It's everywhere.
A world of wonder, a world of water. I've been thinking about all the water in our world.
Fresh water, salt water, water in the sink. I've been taking more time to think. Why do we need water in this world?
We need water for crops and water for grass. We need water for plants and animals too. Everything needs water, everything needs water.
I know that's true.
A world of wonder, a world of water. I've been thinking about all the water in our world. A world of wonder, a world of water. Have you been thinking about all the water in our world?
number one. Oke, okay. Okay, tadi itu pertanyaan di bawahnya ada question 5. Answer the question. Circle four things that need water. Ya, tinggali empat hal yang memerlukan air. Dan dua, is there water inside you? Apakah ada air di dalam kalian? Yang ketiga, invent a new title for the song. Oke. Okay. Title-nya itu yang The World of Water, kalian disuruh merubahnya. Kira-kira apakah judul baru yang cocok untuk lagu tersebut? Oke, okay, sudah. Jadi itu tiga pertanyaannya. Oke. Okay. Aku tadi sekaligus mengakhiri perjumpaan vocabulary kali ini. Semoga apa yang aku sampaikan kali ini bisa bermanfaat bagi kalian semua. Oke. Okay. Terima kasih. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.